Back to Transcription Tuesday, everyone, this time in 2022. Donny Benet has been one of the most requested artists that I've seen in the comments down below, and I even got a special nudge from Lobster himself to check out this song, so I figured this would be a good way to start the new year off. There's not a whole long to necessarily go over with this song because it's straightforward for the most part, just a lot of syncopations, but the trickiest by far is the octave movement throughout the song, specifically in the chorus right here. That movement of the going from the D octaves to the C sharp can be quite a pain. So I'd recommend obviously just taking it slow like any other riff that can cause you issues. But even more helpful than that, I would say, is just to practice doing octaves up and down the entirety of the neck. So you really get used to that motion. I mean, obviously repetition, just for the sake of repetition, is good to get the feeling under your fingers solidly, but then also going up and down the neck helps to account for the difference in the fret spacing. Obviously, when you're playing octaves down here on the first fret of the E string and the third of the D, it's a lot wider than if you're playing all the way two octaves above. at the top of the neck. So I'd recommend starting on the E string, doing an octave, and then just going one fret from there up the neck and down the neck. So there's a few ways you can think of doing this. You can start, like I said, on the open E string and just go all the way up. Oops. On the E string itself. Or you can also jump up to the A string once you get to the fifth fret on the E, like this. And then continue the rest of that exercise up. And then once you get to the top of the neck, then just bring it all the way back down. You can also do that exercise alternating, starting at the top of the octave. Which does feel a little bit weird, but it helps to especially implement the riff in the chorus. So as far as technique's concerned, that's really all there is to this song. Just another thing to keep in mind, although it is a very repetitious song, the chorus and the verse don't really vary that much. At the end of the song, where it does the instrumental interlude and then the outro chorus, there is a different, very minor differences in the syncopation, but enough to throw you off if you're not paying attention and you're just kind of playing the riff by memory. So just keep an eye out for that. As always, thanks for watching. Make sure to do all the typical YouTuber things they ask you to do, like, subscribe, comment, all that fun stuff, and we'll see you in the next video.